I'll come to our thought for the day. I'd like to read you a verse from Psalm 116. It's verse 1, and it says this: I love the Lord because he hath heard my voice on my supplication. The little title I've given is simply this: The Beggar Blessed. The Beggar Blessed. You see, there may be many reasons this morning why you love Jesus. The Bible states very clearly that we love him because he first loved us. Isn't that incredible? He loved you first. He loved you in your sin. He loved me in my sin. And he still loves us this day. That's wonderful, isn't it? But here in our text, this is a great reason why we should love our Saviour. And that is simply because he hath heard our voice. He knows our need, and the fact that God, the God of all creation, hears you and hears me and understands your need today should fill our hearts with wonder and with gratitude, with joy and with peace. Because the all-powerful one waits to hear you call, waits to hear you ask. And when we call, when you have a need and you call upon him, then he answers. Call upon his name today. If you've got a need today, call upon him. Don't wait. Call upon the name of Jesus. How strange it is, friends, that if a beggar came and knocked on your door today and you gave him what he asked for, and then within a month or so he came again and he knocked upon your door again, maybe that you begin to get a little bit annoyed. And then if he started to knock each week and continued to expect you to give to him time after time after time all that you desired, you would say, I've given you once, I've given you twice, but I do think that you expect too much. Perhaps you shouldn't knock again. But if he said in reply, I intend to continue to come, I intend to continue to knock, and not just once a month or a week, but every morning and every evening, you would say, well, I'll lock my door. And I'll not answer. But what if he said, I intend to come each hour? I want to come every minute. Every time I have a need, I'm going to come to your door and I'll expect you to give me what I need. You would soon grow weary of him and wish that he would go away, go somewhere else, but not come to you. Yes, it's true, friends, that this is exactly what you and I do each and every day of our lives with God. And he has never complained. And he has never sent us away. I'm sure that many of you have done it even this day, but rather he has complained because you haven't come and asked him enough. Never complains that you ask for more. Never complains that you seek him. Never complains that you keep on and on saying, Lord, I need you. But he complains that you don't ask enough. For he said to Jacob, thou hast not called upon me, O Jacob. Christ has never complained, friends, of the frequency of your requests through prayer, but complains that you have not called upon him enough. Oh, keep calling upon Jesus. Call upon him more and more. The unchanging willingness and desire of God to hear his children cry unto him is unlike any human being. We know that's why Jesus has to teach this lesson by contrast, rather than comparison. Remember, he delights for you to call upon his name. Luke chapter 11 and verse 9 says, ask and it shall be given unto you, seek and ye shall find, knock and it shall be opened unto you. And we who had nothing and were beggars are now blessed in Christ, blessed to be the very sons of God. So call upon your heavenly Father today, for he meets every need. God bless you. Look forward to speaking with you again tomorrow morning.